Atoms are the microscopic building blocks of all matter. Everything in the world is made up of atoms, from plants to toys to people, like you and me. Now, we're not talking about just a few atoms. Average-sized humans are made up of 7 billion 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 atoms. But how do these 7 billion 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 atoms stay together? Well, atoms join together with other atoms to form molecules, and these molecules join together with other molecules to form substances. These atoms and molecules are held together by the power of chemical energy. Chemical energy is a form of energy that is found in everything. As we just discussed, it is the energy that is stored in the bonds between atoms and molecules. Since it is energy that is stored for later use, it is considered a form of potential energy. Food is the most important source of chemical energy for living things. When we eat food, like a delicious and nutritious apple, for example, our teeth and the muscles in our jaw break down the food into tiny pieces while we chew. When we swallow those pieces, kinetic energy, which is the energy of motion, allows the muscles in our esophagus to push the food particles down into our stomach and small intestine, where acids and enzymes continue to break them down and begin to take out the highest energy-producing molecules. During this process called digestion, our body harvests these energy-rich molecules and stores them away until we need them. In this stage, the chemical energy is potential energy because it has the potential to provide us with energy, but is currently being stored for later use. When our bodies require energy, the bonds between the molecules will break down and rearrange the atoms into different molecules that release energy. The process of bonds breaking down and molecules changing is called a chemical reaction. Some of the chemical energy from our food is used to trigger this chemical reaction, and some remain stored in the molecules to hold them together and be used by our bodies later. But the rest of the energy is transferred into kinetic mechanical energy and heat energy. The kinetic mechanical energy allows us to use our muscles, and the heat energy, or thermal energy, keeps our bodies at a healthy temperature around 98.6 degrees. Without food, we wouldn't be able to do fun things like ride a bike or play sports with our friends, and our body wouldn't be able to keep us warm enough to stay healthy. So, the next time that you eat a nutritious meal, take a second to appreciate all of the amazing things that it will do for your body.